All right, so let's look at the structural directives here and test them out. I'm going to start with the ng-if. And so let's put on here another h3 tag, perhaps, or an h5 tag. And put here, hello world. And let's see if we can mess with this. So here's hello world, h5 tag. Let's go over here. There it is, on the left. Now let's add the directive asterisk, ng-if, capital I. Let's set that to true. Make sure that shows up this way. And there it is, it shows up. And let's go back now and change this to false. We're going to change it directly to false. There it is, it's hidden. Now, not pretty common for you to do this in your code. You wouldn't just hard code it false, otherwise you just delete it, right? So let's create a variable here. Let's call it again toggle, type boolean, and set that to true. And replace this variable false, or the word false, I should say here, with a variable toggle. And now it's set to true, so we should see it show up. There it is. And now let's change it in JavaScript here to false and make sure that thing is hidden. And there it is, it's hidden. So later on, we'll see how we can modify our JavaScript and this will update in real time. So let's leave that up there. And now let's do the ng F4, which is the old ng repeat. And so let's put an unordered list here. And here let's put a list item. There we go. And let's create a real quick an array down here. Let's call it my, let's see, people type, let's say, array of string. And let's set that to an array of person 1, person 2, and person 3. There we are. We're set. So now in the li here, we're going to put, the asterisk, ng4. And let's set that equal to, again, we have to say let. The variable I want to define is each part of that array every time it iterates through this loop. So let's say person for singular for people, which is a variable I defined down here. And since I defined it here in my JavaScript, of course, I have access to it here in my template. So between the li tags, and again, keep in mind, the li tags are the ones that are going to be repeated because of this. Between them now here, I can use, this actually is interpolation, but we'll talk about it a little more later in the next chapter. But we'll put here person to print person there. And whoop, let's double check real quick our code. ng4 let person for people. People is defined there. Array of string, that should be okay. And let's just check real quick our console to see what's wrong. Kind of nice actually. Angular gives you some really nice descriptive errors, so it'll be kind of easy for us to identify what's wrong with it. So let's take a look. Cannot bind to ng4.4 since it's an unknown property. Let's go back to it. It's of. I have to apologize about that. So you say ng4 let person of people, and that's going to give you each part of people into person in just a loop, right? So that should work. Let's go back.
It's always good to see what an error message is going to look like, because after all, everybody's going to get error messages at some point.
Sometimes you learn the most out of them.
Yeah. Right?
You fully understand how they work. So there it is. There's the ng4 right there. And you can imagine, we have an ng4 here. We can even put the ng-if inside of the list item as well, and have those perhaps toggle true-false. I put it false, and now we won't even see them come up. You can definitely combine those as well. So again, just to wrap up, we show how we can use ng-if to hide and show elements, HTML elements. And of course, we can do that by setting the Boolean property into one of our JavaScript variables. And we also show how we can repeat elements for as many things that are in an array. So if I want to show a list of items, I can do something like we see here. Let me delete that real quick. ng4 let person, the variable person being the individual piece of people being the array we're given. All right.